Folks, if you're like me, you've probably seen a lot of the recent images and videos of the war in the Ukraine going on, and you probably thought to yourself, this doesn't have enough me! Well, maybe if you're one of these deranged Twitter folks, I guess that might be your reaction. Hey, welcome here, folks. My name's Nesquik, and today we're going to take a look at some amazing takes. Isn't that what we like to do here, folks? Just look at people, gawk, and laugh. I don't think I need to tell you that we live in fascinating times, shall we say? You know, things are getting a little crazy out there, right? And really, could it be any more crazy anywhere other than Twitter? It is interesting, though. This is truly the first war that's happened while social media has been a thing, really. I mean, yeah, sure, you got the Syrian Civil War, and you got, you know, various drone bombings across the Middle East, but that was brown people dying. So who gives a shit, right? These are some fucking Ukrainians and some Russians, and you know, who knows who else here in the future, right? So, no, people are actually paying attention. And of course, when a gaggle of idiots pays attention to anything, you can best believe that some just juicy takes are going to fall out, right? Now, I'm not just recording this video for posterity, right? I'm laughing at these people and making sure future generations can see what happened. But I mean, let's be frank here. I want to analyze some of this shit because, yeah, haha, it's kind of funny. But you have to wonder, how the fuck do these people, which are seemingly normal-ass human beings, kind of just devolve over time into just rambling insane shit? Let's get into it, shall we? Russian-Ukrainian negotiations are underway. Just look at the Ukrainian delegation.
Where are the women?
Sorry, I had to read it exactly like that. Now, I want to make something clearer, folks. I've done what I can to vet out the tweets that were clearly bait, that were clearly just bullshit, leaving us only with ones that I'm pretty sure are actually legit takes. This one, though, I can't tell because, unfortunately, she has been cut off here, right? Like any proper woman, she's been silenced, but apparently not soon enough before she could just say something just amazing. Just... You know, oh, your country's being invaded? There's not enough women at the table. Like, how about you shut the fuck up? Let's just keep it real, all right? If this is your top priority, you're a moron. And actually, we're going to see a lot of this here, folks. We're going to see people who, they do this not just with war, but literally any news topic that comes up. They take a topic and they try to kind of convert it into their victimhood, or they kind of convert it into their cause, right? Actually, here, you'll see what I'm talking about in a few minutes, all right? This is exactly what I'm talking about. This isn't discussed much, but Putin very much benefits from white privilege. Would you mind specifying what kind of white? Because, you know, white people come in all kinds of flavors. You got fucking, you know, Anglo-Saxons, yes, but then you have Ukrainians, you have Russians. You know, are Italians and Irish people and Spaniards, are they white? They didn't used to be white. You know, you gotta love it when these race-baiting racists can't even properly define white for you folks. It actually kind of brings up just how silly race as a concept kind of is and how ever-changing it is. But, you know, whatever. We're probably talking a few degrees above our pay grade. I can't see a scenario in which a black or brown man running Russia would be allowed to invade Ukraine with no devastating consequences. See Crimea in 2014. White supremacy will destroy us all. Okay, dude, I don't know if you know this, but people really threw a shitstorm over the Crimea thing. Also, I can't see a scenario in which a black or brown man running Russia... just end it right there, actually. Russians, you know, they like their ethnic Russians over there, right? just say it, you know? Once again, the whole kind of white supremacy will destroy us thing, I've looked this person up a little bit on Twitter. She's exactly who you'd expect her to be, quite frankly. You know, once again, people have to put things in terms of what they're trying to sell, in terms of what they're trying to bitch about. You know, this is a black woman who, as you can see, is pretty much on and on about race relations and racial equality, and so she has to make this tragedy where, functionally, white people are killing white people into a parable of racial inequality, somehow, some way. Russia says it has neutralized all of Ukraine's air defenses. Basketball terms? And then you just see idiots spouting off more and more dumb basketball takes in the comments. I love it. They say the word neutralized, and all the basketball retards pop their heads up like, basketball? Oh, we're using basketball terms? It's like, wow, you people are fucking retarded. I feel like I am watching George Floyd die again, only the country version. We all stand around knowing this is wrong, but helpless to stop it. What can we do? Hashtag, Ukraine is George Floyd. I had to look this one up. I am pretty sure this one is actually legit. Like, this person, this Lily Cat's Meow, is actually this retarded. So true, Queen. Okay, that might be a joke. I presume it is. Oh, Anna Lynn McCord.
Dear President Vladimir Putin, I'm so sorry that I was not your mother.
Okay, I think we've all seen this one. Everyone has collectively taken a shit on this woman, and rightfully so. I want to be your mommy, basically. Which is weird, because I want her to be my mommy. Anyways, though, I mean, you've seen this video before. There's tons of people that have dissected this thing. I don't need to get into it. This is just... Actually, here. I will say this about it, okay? If you look in the top right here, you can see Miss Annalyn McCord fancies herself a actress. Okay, I'll buy that. And then a human rights activist, too. Anti-human trafficking ambassador, right? Okay, look. I don't know what she's done to help those. Let me clarify here. Human trafficking, slavery, awful stuff, right? I like that people speak out about it and do what they can. But I'll just be frank. If this was her idea of stopping Putin, what the fuck is she actually doing to stop human trafficking? And this kind of comes to this weird thing, and maybe I'm getting a little ahead of myself here. This is probably the topic for a future video. But I'm going to discuss this kind of theory I have, this kind of thesis, this idea that's been sloshing around in my head for a while. It's this concept of the hollow person, right? It kind of describes a lot of people in modern society where they have nothing. They have no faith in themselves. They have no faith in a higher power. They have no drive. They have no purpose. They just mindlessly consume. They, you know, oftentimes do things that don't take a lot of effort. They're very lazy, very short-term gratification focused, right? On a fundamental level, they don't have anything to believe in. They don't have any skills or products they create. They have no sense of community, and they've been told to hate their nation state or even hate their own ethnicity, right? You know, these are people that, like I said, they're hollowed out. They have nothing. They're skin deep. The things that make people real and the things that give people character and give people purpose, right? They're lacking. And so a lot of times you'll see what these people do is they'll try and fill that void via very chintzy, very lazy social activism. The definition of keyboard warriorism, right? It makes them feel better about themselves while doing the minimal possible action. And anyways, I feel like celebrities are kind of like the Olympic League of that, right? Celebrities are people that frankly know that they don't deserve the levels of attention and fame that they have. So they kind of feel really, really bad on it subconsciously. Like, oh, I need to go out and do something, right? I need to do something on my platform. I need to speak out. No, you don't. You really don't have to if you don't want to. Don't feel like anyone's obligating to do jack shit. You know, people gave you the money and the attention because they liked how you acted. They liked how you were in that movie or TV show. They don't actually really care about your opinion on politics or whatnot, right? But a lot of these celebrities do feel possessed to do so because, once again, what they know what they're doing and who they are fundamentally is very hollow, right? And so anyways, that's, I think, exactly where this kind of shit is born from. Oh, and by the way, I know someone out there is going to be like, Nesquik, they're raising awareness. Okay, you know, that's cool and all, but raising awareness is like the sending good vibes of shit. Like, most people are aware of the problems of the world, okay? You don't need to tell people that slavery exists or war is bad. Like, come on. Raising awareness is the fucking participation trophy of activism. It's the thought that counts. No, it's not. It's the action that counts. It's the action that's only ever counted. Just saying, right? So, thank you, Miss McCord. You truly are a stunner, aren't you? Okay, so besides it being economically painful, why can't the rest of the world get together and airlift everyone in Ukraine out to wherever they want to go with full citizenship? Give Russia the land and then stop doing business with them.
Really, nigga?
Truly an amazing take. Just a breathtaker, right? Hey, these people who want to live in their land, well, someone wants their land more than them. So fuck them, you'll just leave. Where will you live? I don't know. Who's gonna pay for you to live there? The government? I don't know. Moving along, of course, we now have this stunner here. Can you please just not be a fucking fur fag for 10 minutes? Like, would that kill anyone here? By the way, I know I'm probably like the last person in this hemisphere to say the term fur fag. You know what? If that's the case, I'm fucking proud to be that person, all right? Some people, when they act like a fur fag, you gotta call them out, all right? You can be a gay furry all you want, but don't be a fur fag. There's a fucking difference, okay? This, do I even need to elaborate? No one gives a shit that you retarded furries have anything to say about Ukraine. You're not helping at all. You're just morons. You're just attention-seeking morons. Oh, I fucking love this one. So apparently we have the official Twitter account of the Ukraine trying to get Russia canceled, which, kind of cringe. You know, I'm call it what it is, right? I'm against cancel culture, and I think this is definitely an example where it's oh my god. Literally, your people are being murdered in the streets. There's been, at this point in time, several hundred, if not even a couple thousand, civilian casualties. And you're like, please remove Russia. Yeah, that's really important. I'm glad we got our fucking priorities straight. Hey, maybe whoever the hell is running this Twitter should, like, get a job. Should pick up a gun, maybe. Should go, like, ferry some food or treat the injured. I don't know. I feel like this is kind of a waste of your talent, whatever meager amount that is. This picture right here, folks, is the most 2022 thing I could possibly show you, folks. Although, I have saved the best for last year, folks. It's kind of a double header, so prepare yourself. As an effort to help people in Ukraine, during the Ukraine invasion, I will be having a sale on my OnlyFans at 50% off for everyone in Ukraine. You know, a lot could be said right now about just general thoughtery, about arguably stepping over people's corpses to sell your shitty OnlyFans, which apparently only half off for just people in Ukraine. Like, how do you even like verify if you're Ukrainian? You know, whatever. But you know, there's a part of me that really, really respects the hustle. Like, this is this is some anarcho-capitalism to the extreme. This is like, I don't give a fuck. I need to make a buck. And you know, I kind of respect that a little, right? It's depraved, but it's smart. You know, I respect that. But seriously though, terrible. Because you see, there's more OnlyFans girls that need my help, including this one here, our grand finale. Thank you, OnlyFans, for banning me. A girl from Belarus, from your platform. Now, I lost my job, can't buy food, and pay rent. Honk, honk. Meanwhile, people who participate more have no problems, but models and cosplayers can't work and get income. Thanks for this, real actions. Once again, I must stress, this is a real tweet. I actually looked this person up because... because I couldn't believe it for a second. For more than a few seconds, actually. So let's break this down, okay? First off, I don't think people from Belarus, or even just the average Russian citizen, should be kicked off the platform just inherently, right? Especially Belarus, which itself is arguably kind of a puppet of Russia, but you know, that's kind of debatable. It's, you know, there's nuances to geopolitics, folks. I'm not going to lie to you on that one, okay? So it does seem kind of like a shit thing to do to kick someone off your platform just for being from Belarus. And I don't think that's all right. That being said... who gives a fuck? Like, actually, who cares? Like, oh, the world weeps for the passing of $5 butthole pics. Like, you know, I don't really think that that's, I don't really think that's that important. Frankly, if you're gonna sell your nudes for like $5 or $10, you don't value them that high. I'm just being honest, all right? So why should anyone else? Also, I like this. I lost my job. Well, maybe you shouldn't have made OnlyFans modeling your job. Just as a little word of the wise there, all right? That was a bad idea. People who participate in war have no problems. My darling, I'm sure they don't. And this is the thing. Okay, that's really the line that stinks, right? You know, oh, they have no problems, right? Like, how delusional do you have to be? And mind you, this is a person who allegedly is actually from an Eastern country. You know, they're not like just some, you know, slovenly Westerner, right? Who you kind of expect to be out of touch with harsh realities, you know? This is someone who, like, them and their country is so Westernized, so out of touch, beyond the pale even, that it's like, war? Is that even a bad thing? Like, who cares, right? It's like a video game? It's like, oh my god, this is peak... it's actually, you could sit here and say it's peak stupidity, but it's not really that. It's kind of like ignorance. It's almost like a mental numbness that's kind of befallen these people, right? You know, in their malaise, you know, as they cram, you know, cheeseburgers down their gullet, as they watch the latest Marvel movie, or whatever the hell it is, right, and they smile over that, they kind of forget and really lose touch with what makes not just the world turn and the harsh realities of the world, but also just... kind of what it means to be a person, you know? What it means to struggle and to overcome challenges, to kind of, to build character like that. The harshest character this woman has to build is the fact that she can no longer sell her tits for, I don't know, like what, $20 a pop at most? It's days like this where I kind of personally wonder if something a little special, the thing that keeps me going, you know? I really, really hope Vladimir Putin himself has been sent some of these memes. I really hope he sees all the hashtag I stand with Ukraine, hashtag, you know, we'll sign this petition to stop Russia, all this bullshit. I hope he sees it. I really do. Because I think he'd get a real kick out of it. This shit is fucking embarrassing. It's misguided, misinformed, and misshapen crap. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Oh, by the way, just want a quick outro this. Apparently this war marks the definitive end of McDonald's diplomacy. I know, very sad, very sad. For those of you who don't recall what that is, there's kind of this weird little quirk to the 20th century and 21st century by proxy, which was no two countries that have had McDonald's have actually gone to war with each other. It's like this weird little observation that's not technically true, but it's mostly true. It's true enough, and it's like a microcosm to a greater concept, right? It's the idea that countries are sufficiently globalized, modernized, and frankly westernized, will find that the risk to reward ratio of war is simply too great. That being that they risk isolating themselves from the international community and from international trade by going to war, and that risk is greater than what they could potentially gain from conquering their enemies, right, or their neighbors or whatnot. Obviously, there's some, you know, ifs about this, you know, oh, Palestine versus Israel, right? Do either one count as a country? How do you look at that? What constitutes a war, per se? Is it firing a couple rockets and that's it? Does that count? What about a civil war? You know, there's complications there, but I think pretty definitively we can say here that McDonald's diplomacy is now and truly dead, and hopefully with it, the neoliberal world order that established it.